we'll see the next type of DACs, that is your R2R DAC. So here we are going to use only two types of resistors. One is R and the other one is going to be your 2R. So here we are going to have with this D2A R2R ladder network, or your DAC is going to be constructed in your inverting amplifier configuration. It is going to use your inverting amplifier configuration. So here you are going to use a feedback resistance RF between the output and the input terminal of your inverting terminal, and on the input side the switches are going to be connected. So these switches are going to be connected to your 2R resistors there, and this switch here in this case, if it is going to be connected to your plus V volts, that means a 1 is going to be given to the input. If it is going to be connected to ground, that means that a 0 is going to be taken as the input there. And between the 2R resistors, I am going to have the R resistor values there. And at the output, the load resistance, if I am going to see, we are going to have the input resistance here to be 2R there. Now we will see the operation of your R2R resistor, R2R DAC there. So we will assume that my B3 bit is going to be 1. So here we are going to assume that this is your B0 bit, this is your B1 bit, this is your B2 bit, and this is going to be your B3 bit there. So here, sorry, this is your B3 bit. So I am going to assume that my B3 bit is going to be 1 and my B0, all the remaining bits are going to be 0. So when B3 bit is going to be 1, I should start simplifying the circuit from the left hand side. So when I am going to start simplifying the circuit from the left hand side, my circuit is going to be like this. So I am going to have here, this is going to be a 2R, this resistance there, that is going to be grounded. And I am going to have here your 2R resistance, and this 2R resistance is going to be connected to B0. This is your B0, that is also going to be grounded. Your B0, that is also grounded. So between your B0 and B1, I am going to have my resistance R to be present, and the other end of this R is going to be connected to your 2R resistance, where my input is going to be B1. This B1 is also grounded. And next, between your B2 and your B1, I am going to have your resistance R, and I am going to have this 2R to be grounded there. And next is between your B3. So here this is B0, B1, this is your B2, and between your B3 and B2, I am going to have a resistance R, that is this resistance. It is going to be connected to a 2R resistor, and the other end of the 2R resistor is connected to B3, where B3 bit is going to be 1. That means I am going to have here 5 volts to be present. So now this voltage we should know. This is your V2 voltage there. Okay. So here this is going to be the V2 voltage there. Now I should know what is going to be the current that is going to flow through this feedback resistance to find the output voltage. For that I have to start simplifying the circuit from the left hand side. So we can see that these two resistances are going to be parallel. When these two resistances are going to be parallel, your output is going to be 2R into 2R divided by 2R plus 2R. That means that it is going to be your 4R square divided by 4R. So if I simplify it, it is going to be just R. So if I simplify this circuit, so you can see that if I simplify this circuit, I am going to have the value to be your R value. Now this R is going to be in series with this R. That means the total resistance is going to be 2R. Now this 2R and this 2R are going to be parallel. So when it is going to be parallel, I will be getting an equivalent resistance to be R there. So now this R and this R are going to be series. Now I will be getting a 2R. So now this 2R and this 2R are going to be parallel. So when I simplify it, again I will be having a resistance R there. So now this R and this R are going to be series. So now it is 2R there. Now how the circuit is going to be is, here I am going to have your 2R resistance, which is going to be connected to ground. Here I am going to have my 2R resistance, and the other end of this 2R is going to be here 5 volts, and this is going to be the V2 volts there. So here we know that this is going to be at ground potential. Your V2 is nothing but virtual ground, because your non-inverting terminal is going to be ground. So when this is going to be ground, for the differential voltage to be 0, my V2 voltage should also be 0. When V2 voltage is 0, This voltage is also at ground potential. There will be no current that will be flowing through this 2R resistance there. So whatever is going to be the current that is going to flow here, all those currents will be flowing through your feedback resistance there. Because this I current will be divided as your IB plus your I1 there. You know that the current run by the input terminals of your operational amplifier is going to be negligible. So I can write your I is equivalent to, incoming current is equivalent to IB plus I1. So here I1 is nothing but the current that is going to flow through the feedback resistance there. Your current drawn by the operational amplifier is negligible. So I can neglect this and I can write I is equivalent to I1. So now whatever is going to be the current I, the same current I is going to flow through your feedback resistance there. For that first I should find I. So what is I here in this case? This is your 2R. This is going to be your I value there. So your I is nothing but phi divided by 2R. So what is the 2R value? We have used 20 kilo ohms. So phi divided by 20 kilo ohms is, phi divided by 20 is what? 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 is nothing but 0.25 milliamps. So the current that is going to flow through this 2R resistance is going to be 0.25 milliamps there. So same current here also I am going to have here 0.25 milliamps to be flowing there. So when 0.25 milliamps is going to flow, what is the output voltage I am going to get? 20 into 0.25. So 20 into 0.25 is going to be your 5 volts there. So minus 5 volts is going to be the output what I am going to get. So we can see here the binary inputs are going to be simulated by the switches B0 through B3. And the output is going to be proportional to the binary inputs. So the binary inputs can be either plus 5 volts or it can be minus 0 volt there. So assume that the MSB switch is going to be B3 is going to be connected to 5 volts and the other switches are going to be connected to ground. Then we are going to Thevenize the circuit to the left of the switch B3. Then in that case the Thevenin's resistance is going to be given as 2R parallel 2R plus R, that is going to be parallel to 2R. So if I add all this, it is going to be here 2R. 2R is again parallel to 2R plus your R. Then this is going to be equivalent to 2R. Again 2R parallel 2R is nothing but R. R plus R is going to be 2R, that is 20 kilo ohms there. So the resultant circuit is going to be like this. And now we, as I said, there is going to be no current that is going to flow through this RTH, Thevenin's resistance. And we are going to see that the current that is going to flow through this 2R is going to be 5 divided by 20, that is 0.25 milliamps. So the same current is going to flow through the feedback resistance RF and it is going to produce the output voltage where V0 is equal to minus 20k into 0.25 milliamps, that is minus 5 volts. So we can see the output voltage corresponding to all possible combinations of the binary inputs there. So you can see that if my input is going to be 000, B0 alone is going to be 1. That means that we are going to have the output to be minus 0.625. If it is 50, it is minus 1.25. So for every step, it is going to be 0.625 is going to be added up. And we can see that my maximum output voltage is going to be minus 9.375 is going to be the my maximum output voltage there. So here we can have a negative going step, that is your ramp, the step pulse there. So your output expression can be calculated like this. So the maximum or the full scale output is going to be minus 9.375 volts when all the inputs are going to be high. So we can calculate the V0 is nothing but minus RF divided by B3 by 2R plus B2 by 4R plus B1 by 8R plus B0 by 16R, where each of these inputs B3, B2, B1 and B0 can be either 5 volts or it can be 0. So now if I am going to have my this one to be high, that is 1, means in that case I will be calculating the value to be minus 5 volts there. So like for different combinations I can calculate the output voltage there. So what is the advantage of going for this method is it requires only two sets of precision resistance values. So when I have more, when more resistors are required, it is more difficult to analyze when I am going to use binary weighted resistor type. And as the number of binary input is going to be increased beyond 4, both the types of D2A converter is going to be complex and the accuracy is going to degenerate.